Secretary of State Mike Pompeo says China must stop persecuting its ethnic and religious minorities. And the comment was made as part of the secretary's testimony on Capitol Hill today in response to questions about human rights abuses. Correspondent Wyatt Goolsby joins us from the State Department. Good evening, Wyatt.
Good evening, Lauren. The Secretary of State says human rights violations around the world, including in China and North Korea, are an issue for this administration. Mike Pompeo spoke with senators about how the U.S. can put more pressure on regimes that persecute people of faith, while at the same time the administration is proposing cuts to the State Department's budget.
We have been incredibly candid about what's taking place inside of China, and not only to the Uyghurs, but to the Kazakhs and Christians. This is historic. The numbers are staggering.
This morning, Secretary Mike Pompeo told members of the Senate Foreign Relations Committee hundreds of thousands of people in China have been or are being persecuted because they're an ethnic or religious minority.
The situation that Uyghurs face in Xinjiang, in China.
Senator Cory Gardner referred to the ethnic and Muslim minority group that lives in the western part of China. The communist government has put more than 100,000 into, quote, re-education camps. Advocates claim those camps are aimed at forcing Uyghurs to give up their cultural and religious ties in favor of loyalty to the government. I asked the senator what more the U.S. can do to pressure the Chinese to stop the persecution.
Well, I think there's global Magnitsky sanctions that should be considered. I think there's reciprocity when it comes to visa travel and denying those who are committing these atrocities visa access to the United States and others. So certainly a lot more pressure the United States could be bearing.
Senator Rob Portman highlighted North Korea, the number one persecutor of Christians in the world. There, Christians practice underground and in houses. Owning a Bible can send you to jail.
I'll be in Korea next week. I'm going to be talking about the human rights abuses that continue in that country, the lack of religious freedom, the lack of freedom of the press, the lack of the ability for people to organize. It's a regime that, you know, continues to stand up for everything we don't support here in America, and we can't be naive about that.
Also, during today's hearing, Secretary Pompeo defended the administration's cuts to direct aid to El Salvador, Guatemala, and Honduras amid a surge in migrants at the southern border. The secretary says U.S. aid to Central America so far, quote, has not been effective. Lauren?
Correspondent Wyatt Goolsby reporting from the State Department. Thank you, Wyatt.